In this video, we're going to talk about speed gains. Now, in my opinion, speed gains could be even more important than overall speeds themselves. So first, we'll define what speed gains are. So when we're talking about speed gains, we're talking about how much speed is increased from one segment to the next segment in line. So if we're talking from pelvis to torso, what was the speed of the pelvis? What was the speed of the torso? And then what's the ratio of increase between the pelvis and the torso? So as we start to work our way from pelvis to torso, torso to upper arm, arm to hand, those speed gains should increase slightly as we go up that chain. But we should definitely see an increase from segment to segment. That allows us to know that our player is transferring energy from one segment to another efficiently, and they're doing it in a way where they're not having to overwork, right? So if you have a player that's trying to create speed, but they're doing it inefficiently by not using the speed generated from the segment before it, well, then they're having to overwork with the next segment, and then that compounds into the segment after that. So really, they're starting to have to work too hard, and then there becomes an issue of stamina, especially on the golf side when you're playing, you know, an 18-hole round of golf or a 72-hole tournament, right, if you're a tournament player. So that stamina and that longevity really becomes compromised when you have to overwork. So we want to make sure that the speed gains are somewhat consistent with small gains as you go from one segment to another. Why I say that is you can also identify if a player is at risk of injury by looking at their speed gains. So for example, if I have a speed gain between pelvis and torso that's really, really low, let's say 1.0, and then I have a speed gain between torso and arm that's 2 to 2.5, now I know that this area is overworking, right? So I could potentially have some potential to injure my shoulder in the long run if I keep doing that, right? If I have a lot of practice sessions, if I'm playing a lot of games or I'm going out for a lot of rounds of golf, I can put a lot of stress in that area because it's overworking more so than the other areas of my body. So I want to try and redistribute what's going on in the other areas to efficiently transfer the energy better. So the way you would do that is you'd go back and then look at, okay, what are the positions that my player is in with their pelvis or their torso that could be causing them a lower ratio of speed transfer, or are they weak in one of those areas and they're just not strong enough to transfer the energy from one segment to another. So once you identify where there might be a lack of a speed gain that you want to improve or even out, then go back and look at the technique, how you like it as a coach, or the strength of that segment to see if they maybe need to get a little bit stronger. But as a result, you should be able to even out those speed gains and see some small incremental increases as you go through the body. Look for next week's video where we'll talk about sequencing and what sequences we look at in your athlete's golf or baseball swings.